They say artists are the antennae for creativity for the masses. Well, that's true. Here at the Princeton Arts Council, we have a lot of creativity. And we're here at the 2018 Open House. Programs, events, memberships, fun-filled activities for children and adults alike. Adam Bierman, Princetonian Now. We're talking to Melissa Kuskin. This is the reason why we're here. And you look so young. How did you get involved and organize such a, should I say, a rather impressive large event?
Thank you so much. I've been at the Arts Council now for about 3.5 years, and I started as an intern right out of Rider University. So I became a little bit more of a hand in this event every year. Now for the past 2 years, this is my event that I put on every year.
When do you actually start hard planning for this event? We're in September 2018.
Oh, man. I would say early as May, I start to think about what this will look like. We try to do something new every year, and I always like doing a really exciting community component, and this year is the paint-by-number mural. So I started thinking about that a while ago because I like something a little different and fun every year.
Can you tell the audience what's in your job that they wouldn't expect as part of your job description?
Sure. Well, as program coordinator, it's really just across the board. So along with the open house, I'm in charge of the An Evening with Bollywood event that's also coming up in September over at the Princeton Shopping Center. So all our free community events, but I also lend a large support in the gallery as well. And just I like being a little, I have my hand in every little aspect of the organization, which is what I like about it.
Well, I'm having a lot of fun. I got to get back to all the events thanks to you. Adam Bierman, Princetonian Now, with the 2018 Open House for the Princeton Arts Council. And we have a celebrity, a longtime Princeton resident, baseball coach, everything, Jim Levine. Jim, how do you feel right now taking over the reins temporarily, we don't know, here at Princeton Arts Council?
Yeah, thanks, Adam. I am serving as the interim director while we look for a permanent executive director. It's great. The staff here is great. The programming is great. The community support of this organization is fantastic. So I'm really looking forward to digging in, helping out the Arts Council any way I can.
Can you give me the big picture? What are you looking about in 2018 in terms of programs, events, membership?
Sure. So I'm sure people are aware that membership has certain advantages in the Arts Council. You get the Arts Card, which gives you discounts in various places. You get discounts on educational programs that we do here. So we really want to see if we can build our membership up to lots of people in the community.
And you're approachable anytime they see you in the street at the Arts Council, they can come talk to you, learn what's going on?
Absolutely. Feel free. My door is open. Just stop by at the Robeson Center, and I'm happy to meet anybody or talk with anybody.
Well, good luck, and I'm sure things are going to go even better at the Arts Council in 2018. We're with John Abbott. Before we get into what you do now, you were working for NPR?
I was a contributing reporter, part-time for WHYY in Philadelphia, and a on-call news anchor for WBGO in Newark.
Oh, wow. Exciting. So you bring your talents here to the Princeton Arts Council. What do you do? What capacity do you work in?
Well, I switch fields somewhat. I'm a music student at the Berklee College of Music, and I teach ukulele and beginning guitar here. I'm going into my second year.
What are the pros and frustrations of teaching music?
Well, it's like any other discipline. It depends partially on the student. Sometimes they're really charged up about it. Sometimes they're trying it out just to see how they like it. And sometimes they just go crazy. Most of the students I get to work with here, especially at the Arts Council, are very enthusiastic and very passionate about learning music. And sometimes, too, they bring previous experience either on the same instrument or, say, the piano or something like that. So it's always great fun.
Someone wants to tinkle the ivory or whatever you want to play, check out John Abbott at the Princeton Arts Council. Hi, Adam Birman, Princetonian Now. I have to admit, back in, I call it my American Graffiti days, I'd ride in my car and listen to WPST. And all these years later, we're with local legend, or legend, should we say, Chris Rollins here at WPST. What brings you to the Princeton Arts Council opening tonight, today?
I love being here. I'm here for their fall open house today. And, you know, they just want everyone to be aware of what's happening here. Come see what they're all about. They've got so many great things going on here today. There's local artists. There's local illustrators. There's ceramics demonstrations going on. There's dancing happening today. Just the whole community's coming together. It's a great event.
Families, kids, membership. Hands-on activities, and Chris Rollins, PST, can I ask, how's the station doing? You guys are surviving everything. You're like
awesome. indestructible.
That's
right. We are here in the community, and we're here to stay. So, yeah, you're right. We are indestructible.
So be on the lookout for the Princeton Arts Council. Become a member, and also listen to WPST and Chris Rollins. Thank you, Chris.
Thank you.
Welcome.